Hello, welcome to my channel. Today I have got another deck to have a walkthrough to fit for the Halloween spirit. This is the Left Vampires Oracle by Lucy Cavendish and the artwork by Jasmine Beckett Griffith. So let me take the cards. And I believe there's 44 cards. It is a Blue Angel deck. I like Lucy Cavendish and Jasmine Beckett's decks. Let's go on to the booklet first. I will not let you go into the unknown alone, Bram Stoker. This deck is from 2014. So the contents, you have 44 cards. The Vampire Lifting the Veil. Who are the vampires? Powerful, elegant, and outcast. The vampire have been most unwillingly into a life which is dark and dangerous. Why would the vampires help me? The vampires have had noble quests assigned to them and that is served innocence. Why work with the vampires? We learn languages best from a person who speaks the language and knows how to pronounce and shape the words. How will you know they are with you? You will soon begin to receive messages in very safe, secure ways from the vampires. They will literally light your way, helping you to see what you couldn't see before. But the vampires will help you with. On one of their wonderful attributes, because of their own struggle in overcoming their hunger, is that they can help you overcome habits, traits that have held you back or created illness, division, and discord in life. Are vampires real? Many people believe that vampires are fictional creation, but all the brilliantly imagined fictions from folk tales told around the fires to the vampires in popular cultural phenomena like Twilight, there have their origins in something true. Within all cultures and throughout all time, there are tales of those who walked the night from ancient Greece. Vampire beings who wore the pelt of the wolf. In Dionysian lore, we recoil at the deadly dance of the Minans who tore their victims into pieces with their hands and teeth, so consumed by the trance bloodlust of the worship of Dionysus. Modern vampire story, Mercy Brown, 1892, Rhode Island. A young woman called Mercy Brown used to spend nearly every day at the Chestnut Hill Cemetery, visiting the resting places of members of her family who had passed as a result of an epidemic tuberculosis. Within weeks of she has taken by the disease that had already ended the lives of her mother and sister, Mercy was buried alongside them in a tomb. Soon after, her father, George, horrified relatives and friends by claiming that Mercy's spectre was haunting him, coming to him every night begging for food as she was hungry. But this haunting was not exclusive. It was not long before Mercy's brother, Edwin, fell ill with tuberculosis, and he revealed he had been visited by the starving spectre of Mercy. Pleading for hunger to end, the townsfolk, along with George Brown, dug up three graves. Mercy's body was not decomposed, leading George and the townsfolk to believe she was now a vampire. They removed her heart, burned it, and mixed the ashes with water, gave this herbal potion to Edwin, still sick from tuberculosis. Marcy Brown's story became legend, and her spirit is said to walk the Chestnut Hill graveyard to this day. Layout for the vampires. Before you begin to work with this deck, please bless or consecrate your cards. To consecrate them, to connect deeply with your cards, and to make a commitment to working with them in a safe and healthy way, because they are strong energies, it is wise to do this. In truth, it is always wise to do this, regardless how light the energies of an oracle deck may appear to be. A ceremonial blessing of your deck. With this deck, I recommend lighting little incense, the vampires, at all frankincense, which is also protective qualities and will banish any negative energies or entities. When the smoke is blowing nicely, pass your cards through once, twice, three times. The vampires of the eye ask to help me now with this, my task. Say thank you to Great Spirit, the universe, the God, and the goddess, and then let the incense stick or resin burn down. I think we all know how to shuffle the deck, and reading for others, we know how to read for others by now. This is the layout, the Trinity, three card spread. A light in the darkness, the path through the night. We have 13 card spread, like a clock or circle spread. The Byzantine cross. And card messages. So let this booklet go. And let's start. This is one of my most used Lucy Cavendish oracle deck. You can see the scratches on the cards. I don't know, I don't find them dark or spooky. I find these doll look-alike characters cute. I don't know, I might be the weird one. I like this type of decks. It matches the little god girl inside me. My sister always calls me God. Anyway. Oh God, I feel sleepy. I think this deck needs cleaning. I haven't cleansed this deck in a long time. twisted, I think, my wrist, right wrist, it hurts. Sorry, guys. I need to be careful. I like Jasmine Beckett Griffith and Lucy Cavendish partnership. I have probably most of their decks they have created together. For me, it is their decks call me, and I enjoy using the deck. It might be a little bit dark, but what can you do? That's just what I enjoy. And actually, dark deck speaks better than the light decks, more like angel decks. Tell me what you think of this deck. Comment about it. Tell me why you like it. Whether you have the deck or you plan to buy it. This is not a new deck. It's almost a 10-year-old deck. If you enjoy my work, please like, subscribe, and share. And I will see you soon with another Lucy Cavendish and Jasmine Beckett Griffith deck. Soon. Bye bye. Ciao.